Evans, author of Entrepreneurship and Small Business. We're just going to talk about entrepreneurship and about Paul's book. So Paul, how long have you been working with entrepreneurs and how did your interest start?
I've been working with entrepreneurs for over 30 years now. I started quite by accident. I'm on my fourth career, by the way, at the moment. I started out quite by accident working with them because I went in to work for an accountant, Arthur Anderson, American firm. I was put into their small business division. And because they're a large American firm of accountants, the small businesses that were going to them were the ones that wanted venture capital. So I got to work with these interesting people called entrepreneurs. I found accounting deadly dull, I've got to say, which is why I left, and then went into academia, which is the second career step. I was a proper academic for 20-odd years, first of all at Warwick and then at Cranfield. And that's where I started teaching entrepreneurship. I started writing about it. I started researching it. And you get to the point, you know, Martin, that you think, well, I'm telling these people how to do it. Shouldn't I try it myself? So I took that bold step and set up my own business, doing a lot of the same things, teaching, training, researching, this time for money. I did that for about 4 or 5 years and thought, well, actually, I've got a book in me. I want to have time to write. In fact, it was the very first edition of Entrepreneurship and Small Business back in 2001. And I came back into academia, this time as a manager, dean of a business school, and that's where I'm at the moment. And if you want to know my fifth career move, it's when I become a professor of skiing at my retirement.
So you mentioned the book, the first edition coming out in 2001. It proved very popular. What do you think differentiated your book?
I like to think that it's an accessible book. It's written in an easily understandable way. And I think Paul Gray McMillan are very good at presenting it, which helps the understanding that students have. But I think the tremendous thing for me about it is I came to write that book because I understood practice as much as theory. Back in 2001, I left practice. I came back to write about practice. And I like to think that the book links theory with practice, how things are actually done in the real world, with the theory of how things ought to be done. So there's an accessible style and that link with theory and practice.
And you're carrying that into the third edition?
Absolutely. I wouldn't lose that. I think the things about the new edition are obviously the cases in entrepreneurship have to be renewed every new edition. And that's very important. Entrepreneurs come and in fact entrepreneurs go. There are some enduring ones. Michael Dell is still there. And of course he's very successful. Other topics become more important. Corporate social responsibility is a very important topic now, and that's been incorporated into the new edition. Gender and ethnicity issues have been brought in more fully than in the past. And then finally, we've had some feedback that we need more information about how to safeguard intellectual property rights. So I've put